I'm currently stood in possibly my favourite arena in Ireland. So hopefully you guys recognise this. This is the first arena that I ever rode my darling Wilma in. And over here is the first water complex that I ever went through with Wilma. So no prizes for guessing where I am today. I've come back to Ireland to visit the amazing Ardeo Sports Horses. So this is the place that I bought Wilma from, and they've been really sweet in keeping in touch ever since she came over to England. And they've invited me back to kind of just have a little bit of a day in the life of them. So they've got loads of really nice horses in at the moment. They're gonna let us see behind the scenes how they produce them. Obviously, they are a sales yard here in Ireland, so a lot of these horses are for sale. Some are already sold and some are babies that have kind of just come in. And they're really kindly gonna show us how they produce these amazing sports horses, because they sell to amateurs like me, but they also sell right to the top of the sport. They've had some horses go off and do 5 stars, which is just incredible. But more than anything, they are the nicest people and they really value training horses properly, which is why I was so keen to buy a horse from them in the first place. And another reason why I kind of want to show you guys a little bit more about them, because obviously when I was over here in October of last year, we were very much on a horse shopping journey and we couldn't really stop and film around the yards or anything like that. But I remember thinking when I was here what an amazing place it is and how fantastic their horsemanship is. So we're gonna journey up to the barn now. We're gonna meet Neil and Mel. It's a family owned business. They run it together. We've also got one of their daughters here, Ruby, who's gonna be helping us out today, being our assistant. So let's head up to the barn and see some ponies as well. Okay, so up to the barn. This is where we drove up and we literally parked just here. Can't remember if I filmed when we arrived. And you're meted with literally the best view ever. Look at all those gorgeous little heads. In fact, there we go. Look at that little dun. I know for a fact that is a 4-year-old dun Connemara. Really want to go meet him because he looks very similar to little Bearsy. So before we head inside to give you a little tour, I want to quickly thank BetterHelp.
I think last year was the first time that I kind of put horses and therapy together. I wasn't actually a stranger to having therapy. I've never spoken about this on my channel, but from the age of about 12, I had really, really severe crippling OCD, which I ended up having to get some therapy for. But with regards to the horses, I'd kind of always seen that as, you know, a separate happy place, and that was obviously until I had my awful fall at Bicton and it just completely knocked my confidence. And in the end it was therapy that helped me unpack that trauma, because we all know that the sport of horse riding, so much of it is up here in our heads, and when our head's not in the game, it not only affects us, but hugely affects our horses. And I think we are a little bit guilty in the equestrian industry of having that, just get back on the horse, just get on with it, just kick, it'll be fine mentality. And it's taken me a little while to realize that that's not always the way forward. And sometimes these kind of big fears can't just be overcome with that kind of outlook. And BetterHelp understands all of this. They make starting therapy so much less intimidating, offering sessions via the phone, video call, or even messaging. It's whatever feels best for you. With over 30,000 licensed therapists, BetterHelp matches you based on your needs and preferences to make sure that you find the right therapist to help you navigate through your struggles. I think it's time we change the narrative and prioritize our well-being. And if you want to try BetterHelp in doing so, you can visit betterhelp.com/Elphick, and that will get you 10% off your first month of therapy. So let's break that cycle of just getting on with it and move towards a healthier and more balanced life.
Ah, good to be back. Hello.
Morning,
good morning. I'm very well. So I'm a little bit late. So we've got Neil and Mel here, the brains behind Ardeo. Can you give our viewers a little introduction for anyone that doesn't know you? What is Ardeo all about?
Yes, so we're on Ardeo Sport Horses. We sell sport horses to both the amateur and professional market. So our main aim is to match the right horses with the right people. So we take great effort in exploring that whole process basically and just really trying to help people find horses that suit them. We've been at our current site for now 5 years.
Such a beautiful, beautiful space this. It is really lovely, amazing.
So we're very lucky. It was a greenfield site. It was a massive effort to achieve all this. It's been a huge journey, but we're here now, which is great. We've got a massive all-weather arena there. We've got cross-country training facility.
You've got so much. Is that a round pen at the back over there?
Yeah, we'll bring you in there. We might actually lunge this guy. This is a new four-year-old. He arrived last week.
He's
and,
cute.
And we'll see him trot in our lunge pen.
Yeah.
Let's see how it goes.
You're a little cutie pie, aren't you?
Yeah, so we're looking forward to showing you all our horses today.
I know,
man.
Well,
we're
it's nice to be back. Yeah, it's really cool, because obviously last time I was here, very much was on horse shopping duty.
Yeah.
And I didn't really get a chance to like, look round, and you know, I was so focused on Wilma, who's doing great, by the way, guys.
So good on the video.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, she looks fantastic.
Yeah, I can't rave about her enough. She's the most perfect horse I could have come back with, which is why I wanted to actually bring everyone along. And I'm really grateful to you guys for letting us come and sort of have a look behind the curtain, because there's nothing to hide here. I just love what you do and how you train your horses. And
oh,
I think it's amazing that you're happy to show
really
all that.
We're really thankful, because there's a lot of detail that goes into it. And it's so much about the match and just really, you know, fitting the customer and the horse. And I know you had that first-hand experience. And it takes a lot to figure out what horses. We do a lot of sieving to get the right horses in, and there's so many horses that don't make it.
Yeah, of course.
So, yeah, it's really, like, thank you for coming.
No,
it was a lot of fun the last time with you, Simon.
You're going into the kind of content creation now, aren't you? Yeah. Right, well, I know that you guys have super busy days here, so what is our first port of call?
Well, why don't we ride through some of these horses that we'll show you now.
I have bought my hat and boots, if I'm allowed to have a sit on anything.
Yeah, of course.
Under one condition is that I'm not allowed to buy a horse today. That was Mum's parting words with me as I left for Ireland. She was like, do not buy another horse. And there is one in the barn that we'll show you a bit later that we're a little bit worried might
It's the right colour this time.
Yeah. We'll see. Right, okay. Let's go and get the first horse ready, and then we'll head down to the arena. Is that the plan?
Let's go.
Yeah.
Brill. Right, let's go. You are so cute. Thanks. I think I saw him on your Instagram and really liked him.
Yeah, he's gorgeous. He's traditional Irish, and he was started late. He just was broken there in November.
Okay.
He probably needed a little bit more time.
Yeah.
And he's actually come from up the road, from the Paul Lang stud, which everybody knows is very well known. They've bred some pretty amazing ones, like Paul Lang Baraka, that Sam Griffiths won Badminton on.
Yeah.
They've had some wonderful horses out of there.
Gosh.
And this is another.
How exciting. And he's already sold, is he?
Yes, he is sold. He's sold and he's waiting for his flight, so we like to keep.
Where's he off to?
He's going to Florida. How lucky is he?
That nice.
Yeah, to Ocala.
Wow.
He will do very well there in the sun.
So what's he doing here now?
So when he came, he was really quite green, and he's come on a massive amount. Very quick learner, actually. So we love to do a lot of starting them like this on the lunge. You see that a lot over here in Ireland. And it just really helps their confidence to make them certain of their footwork and their confidence in the water and jumping up banks. It's just amazing to have this water jump right beside the arena.
Yeah.
So every day you can walk through the water, you know, sometimes we would always say, you know, with the greener ones, they can often be either cautious of a ditch or water, and it's often one or the other, it's never both.
Yeah.
And you know, you want to suss out fairly fast which is it, and then you take some time to show them, and then once they understand, they never look back.
Yeah, it's so nice that they can just come out and do this as much as you need to get them really strong.
Yeah, I'm so thankful that we've got this set up like this. William Nicklam put it together, which was amazing. You know, William did the
big jump.
produced that amazing bridle.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's great. Look.
Oh my God, he's literally pigging for fun.
Yeah,
because I remember coming here with Wilma and you were just like, yeah, just go and pop down the bank and up there. And internally I was like, what? These are, because they're quite sizable, like they're not little banks, and into water it's quite technical.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
She just popped up really relaxed, and you can see that, yeah, this is how you get them to that point.
But once they know it, then they know it, and you can take them anywhere and they're confident.
Yeah.
It's all about understanding, and I think understanding means doing things slowly.
Yeah, 100%.
And that's, I guess what's going on for this guy.
Yeah. No, I love that that's what you guys are all about, because there's too many horses out there that just get rushed. And they can look really good at the start and be pinging really high, and then in a year's time they've scared themselves.
Yeah, it's, and nice actually to that have. Pinging high is often, you know, showing a little bit of, you know, fear, or, you know, they need to feel like they can walk up and look at it and understand it. And, well, we always say that if you were to, I always say when we're coaching, if you were to interview the horse afterwards and say, excuse me,
how was that for you?
How did that go?
Yeah.
Do you know, some horses, they don't know what they've done.
No.
They're shocked.
That's so true.
Which is, I always think they have to be able to say, like, you know, if you think of Wilma going through what she does, she needs to be able to say to you, oh, I really enjoyed that.
Yeah.
That was fun. I saw the ditch and, you know, the blue and white jump, or, you know, whatever it is. But they often don't. They are so freaked out or pushed too quickly.
No, that is so true.
But, yeah.
Is that our session done?
Good.
Wow. Love that. Nice little splash through the water. Who have we got next then? What's our plan?
So our plan now is to show you a fabulous gelding. He's a 16-2 chestnut fella. He's
Ooh.
6. Yeah.
And is he not sold yet?
He's,
is he currently on the market?
Arrived, yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. And a really nice mare that I have been enjoying riding. She's come about 2 weeks ago. She's fabulous to a jump and very just genuine, positive mare.
So oh,
she
good.
Is. She likes
good, I love that.
Getting there. So you'll enjoy her.
Oh, wow. Amazing.
Yeah.
Right.
So we'll get them tacked.
Watch you ride around.
Yeah,
and then maybe
like
hop on myself.
Her pony Rocco.
Oh, yes. Show us how it's done, Rubes.
Yeah.
This is Ruby's pony. Ruby's 8 years old, and she's a member of the Bray Pony Club.
Hey.
She loves this old pony.
Rubes, are you the next top jockey for Ardeo?
I don't know.
You're like, yeah. Right, well, so is Rocco going to ride around whilst we're out there?
Yeah, well, Ruby will help me show the next horse, so let's
a thing
see,
or two.
Let's see how that goes.
Yeah.
And we'll get Rocco tacked up, and then I'll get on my horse.
Hey, double chestnut, I think.
Yeah. Matching horses.
There we go. So surely we should be keeping the nice dun gelding for Ruby to take eventing in the future.
Yeah.
I reckon that'd be a good idea.
We do have to sell some of them. Unfortunately, we can't keep them all. So.
Do you ever get some that come in that you're just like, I'd love to be able to keep this to have for
yeah,
myself?
Yeah, Mel's mare, Ardeo Gold, was a really sweet one that we had here. How old was Ivy? Two years ago? Over 2 years ago now.
Yeah.
And I think Mel would have done anything to keep her. But unfortunately, that's the nature of our business. We have to let them go. And that mare was really sweet with our kids. Like, you know, our kids could lead her to the field, and she was a real sweetheart.
So yeah.
She was one, but that's the way it goes.
It is nice for the horses that they are around the kids so much, though. I think that's a good test of character for them if they can deal with what kids have to throw at them.
Yeah, it's funny because a lot of the horses that come in haven't seen ponies before.
Yeah.
So it really causes great excitement when they see little ponies.
Having little Rocco.
Yeah.
Oh, bless.
And you'll meet Ivy later. She has a little pony called Amy, so no doubt she'll be out riding.
Back in the arena, is this pretty typical that someone will be riding and then someone on the floor to sort of help out a bit?
Yeah, it's well, definitely we're taking videos. It is a sort of a three-man job, but yeah. yeah, I mean, he's new in this horse, so we haven't promoted him yet. So yeah, immediately we'll both be down here. Yeah, one of us is riding him, and we're just figuring him out and seeing what
sort
of
guy
he is. this is quite a, well, we love the arena, but it's quite a tricky arena. There's a drop off there from our house and our kids can be going crazy. and below there's sort of a drop off there and lots of ditches. So it's quite atmospheric here. Mm-hmm. So you can see quite quickly what you have, which is crucial because...
As I say, yeah, it must actually work in your advantage a bit, that if you've got something that's going to muck around a bit, yeah, well, they'll do it here.
Yeah, they will. And then you just, obviously, attitude is everything. So you just want to have a nice horse, and we want to sell nice horses, and we want horses that are safe. And,
yeah.
Whether they're top level or for an amateur, it's, I think, characters, we would put characters number one.
100%. That was definitely one of the biggest things I was looking for when I was coming over here. I love how we've got Ruby just trotting behind. You guys should do mini majors. He's smart, this one. I like him.
Yeah, he's lovely. He's
really lovely. Smart.
Yeah, he's really nice, actually. And he'll probably go, you know, he'll do amateur or professional for what we've seen.
Yeah.
He's got loads of jump and he's very level-headed.
Yeah.
So,
when do you expect that he'll kind of be on the market, or have you already got clients that you think he'll suit?
Yeah, so often actually we don't advertise. We don't advertise everyone. So there would be a few people in mind probably for him. But we've been getting into the reels. You've been encouraging us. Actually, we've learned a bit.
Yay.
So it's quite fun making the reels. We've had a bit of fun changing it up. So yeah. We might put them out there.
So what is best for people to do then? If they're looking to buy a horse from you, are they best going on their website giving you their details and then you'll kind of match them as and when you have something come in?
Yeah, either directly WhatsApp Neil or to go on the website. We have a form that brings it right in. And yeah, just it's really good to pick up the phone or text. It works so well, I guess, when people are really genuine and honest about what they're looking for and the best description they can give, and maybe videos of their riding, and then you just suddenly can get a picture of, right, that's what would suit. And then suddenly when it comes in, you think, it would suit that person.
Yeah, so, yeah.
The match is everything, the fit, you know, as I guess you discovered yourself.
Well, exactly. That's what I really liked about you guys, is you were really honest, because you had other horses in when I was here that potentially I'd be like, oh, that's super smart, like that would be nice. But you guys sort of knew exactly what I was after and my kind of riding ability. And Wilma and I were matched perfectly.
Yeah, it was actually amazing. Yeah, and when you messaged us initially, we don't always have it, to be honest, because supply, you know, finding the right horses is the tough side, actually. That is the tough side. And in your case, it was amazing, actually, what you described you wanted. And I thought, oh my goodness.
We've actually got this.
Yeah.
Literally down to the breeding and everything. Yes, so I was like, I really want Connemara Thoroughbred cross.
Size, what you've done.
Yeah, no, she'd tick all the boxes.
Yeah, and then it worked. You know, you came, you tried, and then we encourage people to, you know, we just want to make sure it's right. So in your case, I guess it was nice for you to have a second try. Then you felt sure.
Yeah, yeah, 100%. It's time to finally put this boots and hats to work. Hey, boy. So this is Hype, who we've seen Neil riding round. I'm going to be the crash test dummy now. Will I be the first non-Ardeo person to ride him?
Yes.
Wow, obviously since he's come here. Exciting. Right, well, I'll be able to give you my professional opinion on who we think Hype will suit at home. Hey, darling. You're going to pop some spurs on because you said he rides a bit better with them, yeah? Right.
Right, leg up.
Oh, God, I hate getting leg ups from people I don't know. Two. Are we going on three?
On three.
But don't go 1, 2, 3. Go 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Oh, my God,
one,
he's big.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, my God. Neil, he's not that big.
You just took my microphone.
Sorry. Well, I panicked as I was ejected into the abyss to eventually land back down on Hype. Good boy.
Right, take a walk around and take your time.
Okay, off I go.
That's the luck.
Good lad.
He just needs a kick. He likes to be told to go for it.
Okay. Good boy. So I feel like this is a good chance for you to talk through a bit. When clients first get on, what are you kind of looking for? Because
we
spoken...
I like that they take their time to get to know the horse and don't rush the whole process.
Yeah.
You know, just take your time, introduce yourself slowly to the horse, and we're in no rush. So we just like people to
Yeah.
slowly get to know them.
Good
especially
boy.
if especially for the amateur riders, you know, it's nice to be able to slow the whole process down.
Yeah, 100%. I think I walked Wilma for like a good 10 minutes before I got into trot. But you do like need that time to actually
like get to know them a bit. Yeah, because you're sitting in a saddle that you're not used to and different tack, and it just sometimes can feel different.
Yeah. Good boy.
I'm going to adjust some of these fences.
I'm like, why are you putting those jumps down, Neil? I said I wasn't going to jump. Good boy. So how many horses would you say you ride a day?
Max 4 or 5.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm on the road a lot, like seeing different horses.
And yeah, of course.
Yeah, so there's a lot more to do than just ride, unfortunately.
Yeah. And so we'll have to come back for another day in the life where we go horse shopping for
yeah.
you.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Oh, it's be like a 10-part series, guys.
Can we bring Abby and...
Yeah, Abby and Simon, they're good at it. He's really smart.
Yeah, he looks really smart. He just likes a bit like Wilma, he's just green.
Yeah. How old is he?
He's 6. And
he's 6.
Very little mileage for a 6-year-old.
Yeah. How big is he?
About 16.2.
Yeah. Out of my height range.
Height range or comfort zone?
Touché.
So don't be afraid to freshen him up, Meg. He likes to suck behind the leg.
Okay.
He's very safe. So you can kick him away, he doesn't object. Then you can just run through the gears backwards and forwards and see what you got.
Oh, sorry, Mel. Coming to join you momentarily. He's got a nice canter.
Yeah, it's fun.
Took me a second to get used to the stride length. Don't steer towards the jump, though, darling. Ooh, good boy. One thing I realised coming here that you guys were good about telling me is it's so easy when you're trying horses to just canter around in this little canter. But you were like, send Wilma forward, like actually see what you've got,
the
chase
same
the gears.
Kind of get up and go into cross country, like let's move them, let's gallop.
Attaboy. Yeah, I could see myself going cross country on him. I'm back. Yeah, I know. I could see everyone thinking like, oh my word, is she actually going to jump?
Gallop, go cross country and you'll be fine.
Seriously?
Yeah, go cross country, think real forward. Yeah, wow.
Good lad. What a boy. Oh, sorry, lad. Sorry, darling. Not a very good balance from me there, was it? Oh, there we go, practicing the angles.
I gallop over some of your oxes.
No!
Think cross country and you'll be fine.
Good boy. That way. Good boy. God, you can really feel him jumping underneath you. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, I like him. That says a lot about this horse, guys, because I am not one for getting on a green 6-year-old and jumping over any fences. Let alone a little double. He's super smart. Really like him.
Well done.
Good boy. And he's forgiving. Like when I got it wrong, he was just like, I'll sort it. Don't you worry up there. Good boy. So what I love about having the facilities here, I had a boy, it's literally like to walk him home, just poodle through the water, just means that like nothing's a big deal for these horses, which is really nice and so important, especially when we're buying them as an event horses, for them to just be so chilled going through water. It's great. Right, mister, we are heading up to the barn now. Have we washed off and popped back in his box? And then we have got Bella down there, who Mel is currently riding. I don't know if I'm gonna be sitting on her or not, potentially, but apparently she's a bit different type. She's a bit hotter, but has like a really mega jump. Like you, chap, you've got a great jump. I can't believe I just hopped on and jumped him. I wasn't actually meant to be riding him. Neil was just like, do you wanna get him on? He is really cool, really, really cool. Right, I'll see you guys back in a minute. I'll just get him sorted. Good boy. Oh, thank you for that. That was really good.
You did great.
We had one miss, but not too bad.
Well, it's nice to see when you're trying a horse, you know, as an amateur rider, that they can cope with that.
Yeah. That is true. They have to be able to put up with it. Oh, so I was actually doing you a favour, just professionally missing him to make sure.
We can do that all by ourselves.
Don't need me for that.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. So where are you actually sourcing all of these horses from? Because I had a job finding them.
Yeah, I know, it is a job. We work with a lot of breeders here in Ireland, producers.
Yeah.
So we're all spend a lot of time on the road looking at different horses.
Gosh.
And then also a lot of people now send them to us to try, so that's really...
Oh, that's handy.
Yeah, it's really handy that they're sent here, so then we really know, because we're riding them in our own arena.
Absolutely.
It makes it a lot easier. So they come from all over the place. Yeah.
Which is nice, because it means then for people coming to buy a horse from you, you've actually done all the hard work of sourcing them from all over the country.
Yeah.
And then people can actually come here.
Yeah.
And kind of, yeah.
And see what
benefit from all of your hard work. Because it is tricky. I mean, when I was here, that's the thing, it's driving all over the place, and then you arrive and you see a horse that wasn't as described.
Yeah, and sometimes the horses can be fine, like, you know, for other riders, but they're just not what you're looking for.
Exactly.
You know, it's all about getting the horse that you want to ride every day.
Yeah.
You
know? Which is why I think your matchmaking sort of mentality towards it.
Yeah,
it's so true.
We've done so much video sales. We've done video sales to the UK and to America as well. And it's just, it's a very different process.
where we get videos from the riders and then chat with their coaches, and you know,
that's quite a lot of pressure.
Yeah, we've been doing it now for a number of years, so
yeah, it's good.
Got pretty good at it.
Yeah, we've been very successful at it, so we feel very confident doing it.
I think it is reassuring, like having actually bought a horse from you guys. I really trusted that if you thought we didn't look good together, you would actually tell me.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't just be like, take the money, they'll be fine in 6 months.
Yeah, we want their clients to be happy. You know, it's meant to be a hobby. So people are spending all their money on their hobby and their free time. So it needs to be enjoyable. So you really need to have the right horse that you want to get up every day and ride. And
yeah, 100%.
Yeah, that's what it's about.
So who have we got here then?
So we've got a 7-year-old mare by Shannondale Sarko. She has done a lot of training shows. She's been ridden by a teenager, and she's here, been sent to us now. She's here 3 weeks.
Okay. She's smart. She's really floaty.
She's a really good mover, and she jumps really well.
She's a really good mover. How big is she?
She's about 16-1.
Okay. And is she sort of available to buy yet?
Or? Yeah, she's available to buy, yeah. Yeah.
God, I feel like a kid in the candy shop right now. Pete, restrain me. And what do you kind of think, like, who's going to suit her?
She could go either road. She could go eventing or she could go jumping.
Yeah.
She's a nice mare that really enjoys her job. So she enjoys, she's forward going, she loves to jump.
I managed to avoid coming down here with Wilma. That was me being
a wuss.
So this is cool. Got some ditches.
Yeah, there's a few little dry ditches, and it's just nice to introduce them.
Ah, yeah.
So they can actually step into them because they're. And I always like them.
Do you know what? It's so hard to find good ditches to introduce babies to.
I know.
Because you just scare them if they're deep with water in. It's just horrible for them.
Yeah, it's really nice that they can step into these.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we've got 3 dry ditches and then we've got our 2 trichanas.
Oh, that's quite meaty, that one.
There we go. Oh.
Has she done this before? Oh,
my
gosh.
Not here, but the cross-country venue that we're bringing you to later, she was being schooled around there.
Ah,
so
cool.
So we'll show you the ones she's done.
Yeah. So good for them to come and do this.
Yeah, because previously in our old site 5 years ago, we didn't have any cross country, so we were constantly having to box the horses to a facility, so it was even more time consuming.
Yeah.
So having this on site is a game changer for us.
Well, I think it's so nice for them to do things in drips and drabs.
Yeah, because you can get bored of doing the arena, you know, you're in there schooling and then you can come down and change it up and
you
can hack up the field and we have a country track. Good girl.
Bit of footwork there.
Do you want to canter over the trichanan?
Yeah, sure.
It's hard to get to this one because of the grass.
Yeah, of course, no worries.
It's wet there, the ground.
Oh my God. You're going to have to do that again. That was Bella. half smart, is she? How big do you reckon that is, Neil?
120.
120? Massive. You ready, Rubes? Let's go. Da-da-da. Come on, Rocco. Everyone's gonna wanna buy Rocco at the end of this. Oh, he's so cute.
This is childhood
dream
stuff for this
camel.
Isn't it?
Nothing else produced
out of
this
day. What you're
doing,
Grant. Canter. Oh, we're going for canter. Woo! Well done. What a little dude.
Okay, Ruby, we're going to canter two fences together and then you're done. Good girl. Come on, keep
Very
going.
Very good. Oh, that was so cute.
Yes, good girl. Good girl. Canter. Get straight.
Good Woo! Well done.
That was excellent. You've made Ruby's day.
Impressive stuff. You make it look very easy, Rubes.
Oh, thank you. Okay, I'll give you a leg up.
Yep, just when I thought we were done. No rest for the wicked. This is a day in the life, so I've got to actually work properly.
Sorry.
Right, can I be ejected less into the abyss?
Okay. On three.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
I was in such a panic about having to jump again, I wasn't concentrating on what you guys are doing. I'm kind of twisted inside, and I don't know where I'm going. I'm just here for the ride, okay? I took one look at those steps and was like, putting my foot down, I'm not doing those. Might be the Prozac kicking in, but she tossed her drink in my face and I didn't even flinch. My mom says love's not easy, just keep your head held high. People will find you pretty, I just wonder where they are. You like my Batman t-shirt, it costs like 50.